let's do the ClO4- Lewis structure. Chlorine has 7 valence electrons, oxygen has 6, we've got 4 oxygens, and we need to add this up here. This negative means we have an extra valence electron. Gives us a total of 32 valence electrons for this Lewis structure. Put the chlorine in the center, it's the least electronegative, and oxygens around the outside, like this. We'll form bonds between atoms by putting 2 electrons there. We've used 2, 4, 6, 8, and then around the outside atoms, 10, 12, and 32. At this point, everything has octets, but since chlorine's in period 3 of the periodic table, we should check our formal charges, because it can hold more than 8 valence electrons. When we calculate the formal charges, we can see that the chlorine has a plus 3, and the oxygens have a minus 1. If we add that all up, it does equal a negative 1, but we want our formal charges to be close to 0 as possible, so we need to resolve that. If we remove electrons from the outside of the oxygens, that should resolve the formal charge of the plus 3 on the chlorine. So we've moved those in to create double bond. So now we can see that the charge on the chlorine after creating these 3 double bonds with the oxygens is 0. Each of the oxygens has a formal charge of 0 as well. And this oxygen over here, the one with the single bond, has a formal charge of negative 1. That makes sense because we have this negative 1 here. So we've used all of the valence electrons that we started out with. We have our formal charges as close to 0 as possible, and the charge of this ion here adds up to a minus 1, just like in our formula. And there's one last thing we need to do. We'll put brackets around our structure to show that it is a negative ion, and then put our negative 1 charge on the outside. So this is the best Lewis structure for ClO4-. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.